In addition to predatory animals, there are also a number of plants that hunt by using amazing methods. One of these is the Venus flytrap, which catches and feeds on insects that visit it. The plant attracts the insects with the charming red color of its leaves, something of which it is totally unaware. The fly is charmed by the irresistible sweet scent secreted by the glands surrounding the leaves, and lands on the plant without much hesitation. While moving towards the food, it inevitably touches the seemingly harmless hairs on the surface of the plant. Upon feeling the fly's touch, the plant suddenly snaps its leaves shut. Locked up between the leaves, the fly causes the leaves to be clasped even tighter, touching the hairs again and again as it flutters. The plant then starts to secrete a flesh-dissolving liquid. In a short time, it turns its prey into a jelly-like substance and consumes the fly by digesting it. The speed of the plant in closing its leaves is faster than the fastest closing speed of the hands of a human. While a person is most of the time unable to catch a fly sitting on his palm, the Venus flytrap easily does it. How then can this plant, which has no muscles or bones, make such an abrupt move? There exists an extremely detailed electrical system inside the Venus flytrap. The mechanical effect caused by the strokes of the fly is transmitted to the receptors lying under the hairs of the plant. The electrical signals sent out by the receptors are carried to the motor cells that cause the leaves to make sudden moves. And finally, the mechanism is activated to catch the fly. As soon as the perfectly designed motor cells receive electrical stimulation, they change the concentration of water within themselves. The cells inside the trap release water from their bodies and shrink. This event is similar to deflating a balloon. The cells right outside the trap, on the other hand, take in excess water and swell. This process occurs in such a swift fashion that the plant closes its leaves at an enormous speed. Meanwhile, the digestive glands in the trap are also activated. As a result of stimulation, these glands start to secrete a solution to dissolve the fly slowly. Although strong enough to dissolve proteins, this chemical fluid gives no harm to the leaves of the Venus flytrap. Thus, the plant feeds on the jelly of its prey that has turned into a bowl of soup enriched by proteins. At the end of digestion, the mechanism that makes the trap close works conversely to open it. In order to activate the trap, the hairs have to be touched twice in succession. Due to this dual action mechanism, the fly trap is never closed without purpose. For instance, the trap does not become activated when a raindrop falls on it. Here, the most important point is that this skillful hunter is devoid of a brain or a similar structure, and therefore the ability to think. Certainly, the plant is not aware of its superb features, which allow it to hunt. All of these apparently point to a system of accurate precision, knowledge, and design present in every detail of it. Unquestionably, the origin of such a design cannot be explained with coincidences or natural phenomena. It is obvious that a superior creator, ruling the entire nature, endowed the Venus flytrap with such a feature. This is the matchless creation of God. In a verse of the Quran, it is stated, "How many creatures do not carry their provision with them? God provides for them, and He will for you. He is the all-hearing, the all-knowing." The South African sundew plant grows in barren lands and even semi-desert. It is created with a very curious hunting skill, which enables the plant to get the nutrients it cannot derive from the soil in a different manner. The leaves of this plant are covered with long red hairs. The tips of these hairs are coated with an extremely viscous liquid, which has a special scent that attracts insects. An insect heading towards the origin of the smell will become stuck in these viscous hairs and start to struggle against one of the strongest adhesives in the world. As the insect struggles to escape, these tendrils start to bend down to better grip the insect. As soon as the plant closes down on its prey, it digests the insect slowly and obtains the essential proteins for itself. After digesting all the edible parts of the insect, the sundew plant opens its tendrils to set up another trap. Interestingly, the strong adhesive, which does not let the insect go, does not limit the movements of the plant at all. Certainly, the fact that a plant unable to move from its place is furnished with such a marvelous skill is explicit evidence for special creation. This system, which is the product of a supreme wisdom, can by no means be explained with coincidences. No one with reason would think that the plant invents such a system. Therefore, the existence and the superior wisdom of the Creator, who gave these properties to the plant, is obvious. All plants feed by the systems created specially for them by God. This fact is stated in the Quran as follows: There is no creature on the earth which is not dependent upon God for its provision. He knows where it lives and where it dies. They are all in a clear book.